could, I'd have to read the actual contract to see whether you have to give them, usually it's a reimbursable thing, so if we don't go forward with the project, I don't know if we get reimbursed for what you did. I guess the potential pitfall.
Yes.
Dale Foster, Earl of Hurd. Carol, you're speaking about the designing aspect of it. Who is the parties or party that would be, well, if a grant was accepted through, would be the designing part, people that would design it?
Honestly, that hasn't been determined at this point. If we get the grant, it could either be a very basic design that we could do out of our office, or we could involve an actual lighting consultant to provide more detail on it.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes, Brian Donovan, Supervisor. Having been a resident in that community for approximately 10 years, I agree that community is well divided. The majority of our community in that community are children. And unfortunately, just like my street is 25 miles an hour, so are the streets in that community, and which, same as my street, most people don't do 25 miles an hour. So again, this is a safety issue. Ron Kerwin had brought up, this should be a community-related issue, because as Ron brought forth, the policing will be less in that area. When you bring light on to darkness, people don't tend to hang in the light, they hang in the darkness. So overall, this is going to benefit the full community, not just the city. I think overall, police will be then focusing on things that they need to be focusing on, instead of resident areas that have problematic issues. So I think as a community, again, as I've spoken in the past, we need to be a community. We don't need to isolate little sections as that's them, and this is us. We are we, not them. That's right here. That way.
Some information about what I'll second.
Any questions? Vote.
Aye.
Aye. As part of the resolution, they asked for a point person, the board to designate a point person, would that be the township manager?
Yes.
Thank you. Update on Schmidt Road.
Since being, I can provide the detailed report to the manager of the line, my company, by numerous photographs, but there's a lot on the agenda tonight, and I'm not going to do this in front of you, so cut the chase, if anybody has any questions, I'll try to address them. I've spoken with Schlapp, and they have advised that they intend to begin the road widening work on Schmidt Road the week of July 31st, so that's next week. To maximize traffic safety, they have requested permission to close the road during daytime work, and they will be posting signs at least 1 week in advance to alert motorists of the planned short-term closure. So the road widening on Schmidt Road is scheduled to begin next week, weather and such permitting. Beyond that, I think there are some potholes that need to be addressed in the short term, and as a township, we need that discussion about resurfacing that road in the coming years. But, as I say, since the primary question is, when is that widening start, and when is that work going to be underway, next week or next spring?
Any questions?
Sherry Schweiger, 109 Schmidt Road, can they give you hours that's going to be closed, do they have?
I don't have that in front of me, but generally, they're going to be working from 7:00 or 7:30 in the morning to about 3 in the afternoon, that's a constant construction work.
Yes, Kristen.
Kristen, that was very long road. Most contractors that are road projects are required to maintain access to adjacent properties, so that people who live in the vicinity of this construction is their housing out. Will this program be required to do that as well?
Of course it will. And they have a history of working with that situation and letting people access to the road. Schmidt Road is very narrow.
Yes, it is.
And it's really not safe to run construction for cars driving by. It's just not enough width, that's part of why they're at.
Well, that's why people in.
So I'm sure the Russos or their tenants would enter their property, they would be accommodated. But as for people running all the way up and down the road, that.
Correct. As needed, they will let people in.
Yeah.
Bob Burns, either go road, will they be required to get road closing permit for that? I mean, I think our ordinance says that when the road's closed, the township has to submit a letter to them and whatnot.
They submitted a request to close the road. I did relay that back on July 9th to the manager and the road master. So I thought they had already had road opening permits, but I can review that with the manager and the road master.
Thank you.
Next, consideration of an ordinance for an open space referendum.
So we prepared an ordinance that in order to place it on the agenda. This ordinance would frame the issue. It would notify, have the effect of notifying the county to place the question on the ballot for the coming election in November. And I think there's one revision to that which we prepared, and then I'll ask the manager to explain what that one revision is.
Yeah, we want to speak to the financial impact of this ordinance. Now, currently, Lower Frederick residents are paying a 1.4% earned income tax. 0.9% of that goes to the school district, and the township receives 0.5%. What we've stated, what we expressed in the last few weeks, we had a special report posted on our website for informational purposes. What's being suggested here this evening is a 0.05% earned income tax increase. Now, that is expressed as 0.0005. Okay, so we're clear on the numbers. That's the way it works out mathematically. And by example, the state has a 3.07% wage tax. And that's expressed, if you look on your income tax forms, as 0.0307. So I just want to be clear in terms of how you express it, in terms of the 0.0005 versus saying 0.05%. That's the clarification. And that's what this ordinance is intended to say.
Great, love it, we got quite a bit of it, but do I think we need it, correct? At what cost? Yes. I appreciate it.
Cam Hartman, Cam, Spring Mountain Road. Mr. Cowan, would you mind if I ask if you were the only author of the petition?
Any answer?
The reason I'm asking is because I didn't get a clear picture on what land the people who started the petition are interested in the township purchasing with our tax dollars.
Yes.
From what I understand, there is no specific properties that have been pointed out to be purchased, but it is for a savings account that can be used as things become available to the township, at which point a decision could be made at that point whether that's something useful. If there is no funds available, nothing can be done. And the township would have missed the opportunity to be able to enrich our environment for whether it be playgrounds or walking parks or whatever. So this is a savings fund specifically for open space, because that's how I understand it's big. If anybody else knows more about the bid, that's fine. But without having funds available, the township has its hands on.
I think I can provide some clarity on the history. In 1995, the State House passed Senate Bill Number 1320, which authorized the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania to preserve, acquire, or hold land for open space uses. So anyone who would like to read that, I'm not going to share my copy, but that is Senate Bill 1320 in the 1995 session. And then that was amended by House Bill 1523, Act 115, which was House Bill 1523, and that the main sponsor of that was our own rep, Marcy Topol, and that revision allowed for open space funds to be used for maintenance. So I would encourage anybody who has some confusion or questions about the purpose of these acts, those are the two legislative acts that lay down what they may be used for. And I just want to note that this was certainly important enough for our Senate and our House to pass these laws. They felt that the preservation of open space is an important use.
Excuse me.
Yes.
A follow-up, please. As a taxpayer who will possibly...
Pam
Parkin, Spring Mountain Road. As a taxpayer who will be paying this proposed tax, I feel that it is my right and the other workers in Lower Frederick to know who proposed the tax for fun.
I'd also like to clarify, we're not voting on a tax here, we're voting to put it on the referendum, and anyone who opposes it should vote no.
There's only three.
No. In November.
Right, but if it goes through tonight, it has a chance.
Yeah. People don't want to vote no.
I'm not getting an answer on who proposed the tax. Is that not when the petition was submitted? Were names not included with that?
Do you want to answer that? You will throw it in your name is not good.
Yes.
Dave Roberts, 1115 Old Gravel Bike. My question is, if you don't pass the proposal to put through as a referendum in this next balloting, can it not go on another future ballot?
Yes.
So it's not the end of it, it's just the end of it on this cycle, correct? Okay.
Yes.
Dan Ward, Cracks Road. I just would like to state that this referendum was brought up to through the appropriate channels. I have nothing to do with the referendum, but it was brought up through the appropriate channels. The appropriate number of people signed it, so that it can be put on the ballot, what, 4-2, and I think it would be inappropriate for us to, and anybody else in this room is, has the ability to establish a referendum for what they're interested in as well. But I think it would be a very poor precedent set to have our supervisors usurp the people of the community. That's not something I would ever like to see happen. If I had worked on a referendum and brought it forth to the township, got the appropriate signatures, followed the right procedure, and then the township supervisors decide that that's not right, that's, to me, that would be maybe a step too far for them. And they should observe the will of people. Some people, I know that Brian thinks it's them, Brian Will thinks that certain people may not have understood what they signed. Well, happy, what is it? Happy out of or whatever the Latin is. But the truth of the matter is, the appropriate number of people signed this, brought formal board in the appropriate fashion, and the other thing is, if people do not want this, they can vote again in November. If they can form a committee and run with the honor, get proper support to vote again. But to take away the potential from the citizens to vote in something that they properly petitioned, that to me is highly questionable.
I'm sorry, what's your last name?
Gentner. I understand what you're saying, but I like what Brian Hill said about. I don't know, I didn't sign it, and I don't know whoever did sign it completely understood what they signed. I didn't see the reference, so I don't even know what it said or who wrote it.
And you can vote it down and do that?
Yes.
Also, Girl Up Road, I would think that putting a referendum on the ballot will, at the time that we have, which is several months before election time, would be the opportunity for people to be educated about whether they are for it or against it and vote accordingly. It would be the time to educate ourselves in more depth. But 300 people signed that, and they had the responsibility of signing something and learning a little something about it before they signed. But they felt they had enough information to put their name on that. Now we can begin to scrutinize the benefits and shortcomings of that. We have time to do that. Nobody's trying to push anything through or hide anything. It is time to think about this issue in an intelligent way for what it will